Every day, Earth is bombarded by tiny meteors. These small fragments of cosmic matter burn up in our atmosphere and have lit up the night sky for hundreds of thousands of years. When they occur in large numbers, we might see a meteor shower. These events are so spectacular that throughout human history, we have folded them into our culture and mythology. The most famous of these meteor showers is the Perseids. But what do we actually know about the Perseids? Where do they come from? How can we see them? And bizarrely, what do these meteors have to do with a murder in the 1800s? Each August, if you glance up at a clear night sky, there's a chance you'll see a shooting star from the Perseid meteor shower. They are known as Perseids because of where they appear to originate in the sky, from the direction of the constellation Perseus in the northern hemisphere. When we think of meteors, we can be forgiven for picturing those big, colossal rocks that hurtle through space and crash into Earth, just like every other disaster movie. But this is not the case. The meteors are tiny, and it's actually more accurate to suggest that we are hurtling through space towards them than to say that they're hurtling through space towards us. Every single Perseid shooting star has the same origin, an ancient comet that darts in and out of the inner solar system every century, known as Comet Swift-Tuttle. This comet is approximately 26 kilometers across, making it comparable to the asteroid that ruined an otherwise lovely day for the dinosaurs when it plunged into the site of modern-day Yucatan Peninsula and wiped out around 75% of life on Earth. But don't worry, this comet shows no signs of being any threat to us whatsoever. Historical records of the comet date back to at least the year 69 before Common Era, but it was officially recognized and named in 1862, when it was realized to be the same returning object. It appeared in the sky as bright as Polaris, the North Star, and received its names from two astronomers, Lewis Swift and Horace Tuttle, who observed it separately in July of that year. Its absolutely massive elliptical orbit takes 133 years to complete, taking it out past the dwarf planet Pluto, before soaring back towards the inner solar system, around the Sun, and back out again. Estimates place Swift-Tuttle's return to our skies in the year 2126, when it will be visible to the naked eye. So, how is this comet the origin of these shooting stars? The comet leaves a trail of debris in its wake, known as the Perseid Cloud. This cosmic stream is made up of ice and dust from the comet itself, but these pieces continue to follow the same path around the Sun. These fragments can be as far as 100 miles between each piece, which might seem really far apart, but consider it's been doing this for thousands of years, building up a river of debris that Earth flies into every August. Each year, when our planet is at this particular part of its orbit around the Sun, it enters the river of dust left behind by the comet, and as a result, it's bombarded by tiny meteors, almost all of which burn up in the atmosphere. Tiny fragments, ranging between the size of grains of sand and marbles or small stones, burn up as they streak across our sky over 80 kilometers above our heads, at staggering speeds around 60 kilometers per second, and form shooting stars for the fortunate spectator to spot. The peak of the Perseids occur annually between the 9th and 14th of August. On average, around 60 meteors per hour can be seen, a rate of about 1 per minute, although this number can differ depending on how much debris Earth happens to pass through, and whether or not a bright moon is illuminating the sky. For thousands of years, people have looked up and noticed this phenomenon. It's so spectacular that it's no wonder it's made its way into our culture, and even into our myths and religions. Some Catholics call the Perseids themselves the Tears of St. Lawrence, since his feast day takes place so close to the peak of the shower. It's said that the meteors are his tears shed over being martyred, and rather grimly, also represent the sparks which ignited the fires in which he was burned to death. Famed Italian poet Giovanni Pascal II also likened the Perseids to tears. His father was brutally murdered on August 10, 1867, coincidentally the feast day of St. Lawrence. The devastated Pascal wrote a poem titled August 10th, in which he addresses the saint and implies that the sky itself is crying, referring directly to the Perseids, due to the evil of humankind. Translated from the original Italian, it reads, "St. Lawrence, I know why so many stars burn and fall through the calm air. why such great weeping sparkles in the concave sky. So, if you want to see this natural astronomical wonder for yourself, what's the best way? Will you need any fancy equipment? Not necessarily. You're in with a better chance if you happen to be in the Northern Hemisphere during August, but the main things you need to hope for are dark, cloudless skies. For the more adventurous, there are websites that will tell you the places that are less affected by light pollution, where you'll stand the best chance of witnessing the event. And keep an eye on weather maps for areas with less cloud coverage. If you're lucky, you might spot a few every minute, and you'll join the ranks of the fortunate stargazers across the ages who have been inspired and awestruck by the dusty remnants of that ancient comet burning overhead.